northwest Cameroon. In this picturesque part of Africa, an unspeakable practice. Grace Tetu is about to show me how she pressed her daughter's breasts with a hot pestle to make her less desirable to men.
Is that the right temperature?
Mm.
And then you press them like that.
Mm.
And then does that flatten them? Away.
The driver.
It drives them away.
Mm.
It's called breast ironing. Some mothers use hot stones, others shells, different methods with one objective.
Do you think that it helped you to be protected from boys looking at you?
Yes, that is why.
So the boys didn't look at her anymore?
Yes.
Teresia was 9 years old. Her mother ironed her breasts every morning before school for several weeks. One day the pestle she used was too hot.
Did she burn your breasts?
Yeah, one time it was not there. She burnt it one day.
Her mother denies the incident. But Teresia is still traumatized.
One mother who came with secondary burn of her hands because the stone she was warming to do this breast ironing burned her.
Gynecologist Sinu Chana has seen breast glands that have been totally destroyed and even one case of cancer.
Now we couldn't establish whether it was the ironing which has led to this or whether the lady had her cancer and then the ironing just came and aggravated the situation.
One of her patients is 23-year-old Kathy Abba. Unable to save herself, she's trying to save other girls by confronting mothers in Cameroon about the effects of their actions. After hearing Abba's story, this mother is remorseful.
There are more than 200 ethnic groups in Cameroon with different norms and customs. What's striking about breast ironing is that it's practiced by all of them. The only known study ever conducted on the subject has revealed that 1 in 4 girls have been affected.
The high rate of teenage pregnancy is thought to be driving mothers to such drastic measures.
So after the training, they come in and auntie.
Now concerned charities are trying to spread the message that the solution lies in sex education and not breast ironing.
Is this what your mother used? On you?
Yes.
Okay.
The challenge is reaching parents like Tetu in far-flung villages before a ritual motivated, they say, by love, shatters more lives. Nkepile Mabuse, CNN, Cameroon.